Are you encountering the issue where the Bluetooth headphone or speaker is connected as voice only? If yes, then try the following solutions. Solution number one is to check the status of the Bluetooth services, and there isn't only one service but three of them, so we'll check them one by one. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command services.msc and hit enter to open the Service Manager window. In the Service Manager window, we will find the Bluetooth support service first. It's all mentioned in the solution number one on the original article. You can check the link in the description section of this video. Right click on the Bluetooth support service, select properties. Make sure that the startup type is automatic and the service is running. If not, click on start, click on apply and then on OK to save the settings. The next service is the Bluetooth audio gateway service. Right click on the Bluetooth audio gateway service, select properties, change the startup type to automatic, click on start, then apply and then on OK. And the last service is Bluetooth user support service. Right click on the Bluetooth user support service, open properties, change the startup type to automatic, click on start, then apply and then on OK. The next solution is to make sure that your Bluetooth device is activated and enabled. For this, copy this command, which is mmsys.cpl. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. Paste the command here and hit enter. This will open the sound properties. Now, one of these sound properties is the one which is related to the Bluetooth device. I have two headphones. One is the Realtek audio one, which is not plugged in because it is a hardware wired headphone. And the second one is the Bluetooth headphone. So this is the Bluetooth device. If it is disconnected, right click on it and enable it and make sure that it has been set as the default device. The third solution is to run the Bluetooth troubleshooter. In order to run the Bluetooth troubleshooter, right click on the start button, select settings from the menu. In the settings menu, go to the system tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, select troubleshoot. Now select other troubleshooters. Wait for the list to load and corresponding to the Bluetooth troubleshooter, click on run. Wait for this help page to load because now the troubleshooters have changed, so it needs a few seconds to load the options. And after that, you'll have to give your consent by clicking on yes. Once you give the consent, the Bluetooth troubleshooter will start in a while. It will check for problems and fix them if possible. The fourth solution is to update, rollback or reinstall the Bluetooth device drivers. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command devmgmt.msc and hit enter. This will open the Device Manager window. Expand the list of Bluetooth device drivers. Right click on Intel Wireless Bluetooth driver. Select properties. Go to the driver tab. Now you'll find the option to update the driver. Click on it and select search automatically for drivers. Now since I have the latest drivers installed on my system, all I need to do is roll back these drivers, which is the second option. However, if this doesn't work either, then the third option is to uninstall the drivers and click on OK after that. Do not worry, once you restart your computer, these drivers will be reinstalled. The last solution is to remove the hidden Bluetooth device drivers. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command devmgmt.msc and hit enter to open the Device Manager window. Click on View. Now click on Show Hidden Devices. Expand the list of Bluetooth device drivers. You'll find a few hidden redundant drivers here. All you need to do is right click on them and select uninstall device and then click on uninstall. Do this for all the hidden redundant Bluetooth device drivers. Isn't this easy and interesting? If this was helpful, then please feel free to subscribe to the channel. Else, let us know in the comments section. We will investigate further. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.